is a fine romance.
Helen!
Hello. Can't stay.
Oh, thanks for coming. Ta-ra.
For long, I mean.
Oh, you're working.
No, any excuse to get away from that.
What is it?
A novel.
Well, you always said a novel was a translator's dream.
Not this one. It's about a man who loses his soul in a plastics factory.
Does he find it again?
Don't know. He's still agonizing. He's been agonizing for the last 80 pages.
Well, cheer up. Phil and I thought we'd eat out tonight. Would you or Mike like to come along?
Oh, no thanks. Coffee?
No thanks. Why not?
Well, I don't exactly know what Mike's doing this evening.
Well, ask him.
I may not be able to. Glass of wine?
No, thank you. Well, would you like me to write out an invitation and then you can hand it to him?
No, it's not that. I just may not be seeing Mike this evening. I haven't seen him for 2-3 days.
You haven't had a row?
No. It's just that sometimes I don't see him. He kind of goes walkabout.
Like an aborigine?
Yes, not with a spear, but it's an approximation, I suppose.
What does he use for an outback? Richmond Park?
No. He doesn't go anywhere. He just doesn't come here. Well, he just feels cooped up. I mean, it is a small flat.
It's cosy.
Yes, cosy, but small. I know Mike thinks it because sometimes he prowls about.
Not on all fours.
No, not on all fours.
Sorry, go on.
Well, it's just that if there are two of you here and one gets bored with what the other one's doing, there's nowhere for the other one to go.
Well, you can always go for a walk round the window box.
You're in a frankly silly mood today.
Yes.
You're pregnant?
I think I might be.
Oh, Helen! Oh, why on earth didn't you tell me?
I just did.
Yes, but before you let me go on about French novels and Mike prowling around and... Oh, how soon will you know?
Well, I'm seeing the doctor tomorrow.
Oh. Is Phil pleased? What did he say? Did he give you a cigar?
Well, I haven't told him yet.
Why ever not?
Well, I want to wait till I'm absolutely sure.
Oh, I would.
Yes, I know you would. You'd have it on news at 10.
Aunt Laura. I can't knit.
I know that.
Oh, Aunt Laura. Oh, no, it sounds as if I wear hairy suits and Lyle stockings.
Doesn't.
Auntie Laura.
Yes.
Oh, no, that sounds like I'm some old dear who lives in the country.
Uncle Laura?
Well, we'll think of something. Oh, Helen. Oh, I'm so pleased.
Well, fingers crossed. Anyway, I must go.
Oh.
Now, what about tonight?
Well, I'd like to come.
Then come. We'll pick you up a date, and if your aborigine hasn't arrived by then, we'll leave him a note.
Okay.
Oh, and one thing. Hmm? Don't say a word to Phil.
Not jump.
No.
Okay.
Three Campari sodas. One for you, signora. One for you, signora. Prego. And one for you.
Grazie.
Are you ready to order yet?
No, we may be expecting Rolf Harris. We'll give you another 10 minutes.
Rolf Harris. Molto bene. A toro bravo. You call me when you are ready.
Phil.
Well, restaurants love celebrities.
Mike doesn't even look like Rolf Harris.
Yeah. Well, the name's... During that time when we tried to get into the restaurant after the ballet, I said I was Wayne Sleep in Lucky Shot.
Didn't dance, did you?
No, I just kept looking as though I might.
Hello.
Hello, Mike.
I got your note.
Glad you could come.
Evening, sport. Do you need another chair? I'll get one. Excuse me. Is it all right if I can... So, what are we celebrating?
Nothing. We're just having dinner.
Oh, well, anyway, it's on me.
No, it's not. We invited you.
No, I insist. I've just had some good news.
Buonasera, Signor Harris. Benvenuto in ristorante mio. What will you have to drink?
What good news?
I'll tell you in a minute. I'll just have one of those.
One Campari soda. Very good, Signor Harris. You know, Signor Harris, you look much younger without your beard.
What good news?
What's he talking about?
Oh, he thinks you're Rolf Harris.
What? Why?
I said you were.
Why?
He's being silly.
Look, what good news?
Oh, I don't look a bit like Rolf Harris.
Now look what you've started.
Well, it's all of the mind, mate. I mean, I don't look a lot like Wayne Sleep, do I?
Who?
Look, if you don't stop, I'm going to get up on this table and scream.
One Campari soda just for you, Signor Harris. Dalla casa, it's under the house.
Look.
Signor Harris, please, you give me your autograph.
I'm not Rolf Harris.
Not Rolf Harris. Signor Harris, it's for my little daughter.
Sign it.
Grazie, molto grazie, Signor Harris.
What good news?
What did you sign, Mike?
Rolf Harris. Oh, I've just remembered who that Wayne Sleep is. He's that ballet dancer.
That's right. I warned you. Well, I'm just going to keep one foot on this chair.
Signor Harris, is something wrong?
No, everything's fine, thank you.
Just rehearsing.
Ah, una prova, sì. Io complimentare.
I'm sorry, it's all his fault.
Well?
Well, the good news.
Yes.
Well, it's all a bit of an anticlimax now, really.
Just tell it! Yeah,
well, it's the business. It's something I'm not used to. I'm in the profit. I'm in the black, that's all.
Celebrazione! Yes, Signor Harris, are you doing a big show?
Well, one mustn't say too much.
Si, capisco. Are you ready to order yet?
No, don't let's order yet. I can't listen properly when I'm eating.
Well, let's have another drink then.
Well, we'll all be smashed.
No hurry. Four more Campari sodas. You know, Signor Harris, you are not so curly as you look.
Oh, what a lovely day this is turning out to be. First
what?
Well, first. And now you.
There's profit, Mike. Huh? You're going to reimburse?
You need a new van.
You need some new clothes.
I need some new socks.
Think you're very big.
Well, let's keep it in proportion. Subway landscape gardening, you know, not ICI.
The difference is you've done it yourself.
Mm. Oh, I don't know about that. But I've already decided what I want to do most.
For comparison.
Si.
Grazie. Oh, grazie. Grazie, Signor Harris, please. For the chef's little girl. Molto grazie, signora.
Well?
I'm sorry about that. Does that constitute forgery?
What have you decided?
What? it's a bit awkward, really.
What?
Well, it's rather rude.
You've decided to do something rude?
No. No, it's just that I wanted to tell Laura first on our own.
Oh, well, we'll go over to the other table. It's all right.
Now, look, this is ridiculous. Look, we're having dinner together. Mike can tell me afterwards.
Yes, that's a much better idea. I'll tell you afterwards.
No, actually, there is something that I'd like to tell Phil privately.
Oh. Well. What do we do, whisper?
This is tough. I'll tell you what. Helen and I will go over to that table. No. Then we can whisper over there.
There.
And you can whisper over here. Then we've all finished whispering what we've all got to whisper. We can come back here and presumably we can all tell each other what we're whispering about.
Come on. Come on, let's go.
Rehearsal.
Well, here we are then.
Yes.
Haven't you better start?
Yes. But it needs words, you see, and sometimes I can't find the right words to say.
Well, try.
I hope you're going to react like that.
You're not going to tell me you're pregnant, are you? Oh, you think so?
Oh, that's great.
Yes.
That's just right for kids, is too.
Yes.
How's your whispering going?
We've not started yet.
We've been seeing quite a lot of one another recently.
Yes.
I mean, quite a lot.
Yes.
And I thought, well, that I was making a profit at last.
Yes.
Well, we ought to put it on a more permanent basis.
Yes.
In a way.
Way, yes.
Well, the thing is, I've seen a very nice flat. It's a big flat, big enough for two people to live in, and I think we ought to live in it.
Let's go and tell her. We're going to have a baby.
I think Mike's just proposed. Smirking.
I can't help it. Fancy thinking I'd propose.
Fancy.
Expect we shall laugh about it one day.
Let's do it now.
Look, it's not my fault you've got hold of the wrong end of the stick.
I don't mind being made to look a fool. I look a fool quite often. It's being made to look an utter and complete fool, I mind.
You shouldn't jump to conclusions. You should let me finish what I was going to say.
It took about 3 hours to get that far.
Well, that wasn't my fault, was it? I had to sign all those autographs.
Rolf Harris. Well, thank goodness we got it all cleared up before the waiter came back. He seemed very pleased with that drawing you did for him.
Yes, he did, didn't he?
What was it meant to be?
A kangaroo.
Oh.
About this flat.
Now, look, Mike, I honestly don't see the point. I mean, we're practically living together as it is.
Yes, but I thought we might move to bigger premises.
You make us sound like a factory.
But it is a bit small, isn't it?
Well, it wasn't.
Well, it never is at first. The more you get used to someone, the more room you seem to use.
Well, we're not giants.
Well, we're not pygmies either.
It's always been perfectly big enough for me.
Well, come round and see it anyway. See what you think.
When?
Tomorrow, after work.
Okay.
Good. Are we living together tonight?
You don't have to ask.
I do. As long as it's your flat I'm living in.
When you park the van round the back, you rather preempt the question.
Oh, you noticed that, did you?
Oh, I'm quick.
What would you have said had I asked you to...
Now, what kind of a question is that?
Well, why, academic.
It's rather late at night for an academic question.
Oh, I'm just curious.
Okay. No. I'd have said no.
Oh.
I've got an academic question for you.
Oh, yes? What's that?
What would you have said if I'd said yes?
My boy Bill will be tall and as tough as a tree. Will he?
He won't, you know.
I don't care if he's short and fat.
Phil,
He
won't be anything.
What?
There isn't a Bill. It was a false alarm.
Oh, love. You're going to see the doctor for tonight. Oh, I'm sorry. You're right.
Yes, just disappointed. And don't you dare say never mind.
Well, I was going to.
Never mind.
I think I'll go and ring Laura, get her to come round.
Why?
Because she's your sister, she's a woman.
What's that got to do with anything?
Well, I suppose I thought she'd know what to do.
Listen, when I am pregnant and there are 10-foot snowdrifts and the car won't start and the ambulance men are on strike, then Laura might know what to do. All she'd do now is to get upset and make me upset. Anyway, she and Mike are looking at a flat tonight. She needs her mind clear. Actually, you know, I think we'd have a girl first.
Then Bill.
Yes.
Well, what do you think?
Well, if it's unfurnished, what are they doing here?
Fixtures and fittings. What do you think?
Well, it has possibilities.
Yes, that's what I said.
What the estate agent says, too.
Oh, good. We're all agreed on that, then. Nice big windows.
Don't think much of the view.
Rather nice. Bit of green, flowers.
In between the gravestones.
Well, at least the neighbours won't be noisy. Oh, it's a good-sized kitchen, too. Nice working surfaces.
I didn't know you were interested in working surfaces.
Oh, only in an academic sense.
Don't think much of the sink.
No, I'll change that. What do you think?
Is that working? I want to phone Helen.
Why? Can't you make her own mind up?
No, she's been to the doctor's. I want to find out how she got on.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hello? Hello? Phil? Laura? What does it feel like to be an ex... Oh, I'm sorry. How'd she feel? Well, perhaps I could pop round. No, 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 it's no trouble. I'll come round. Bye. False alarm.
What?
What a horrible expression that is.
Oh, what a shame. Still. Well, where are you going?
Going to see Helen.
But what about the flat?
Well, I can't think about that now.
But you must think about it now. We're first, but there's a queue. And if we don't make up our minds, well, then somebody else might take it.
What a callous thing to say. You think a flat's more important than a baby?
But there is no baby.
Oh, well, if you hold human life that cheaply...
Ah, now, what are you talking about? It's a shame, that's all. It's a shame. Phil and Helen are young. They'll have thousands of babies if they want. You know what you're doing, don't you? You're making this an excuse to wriggle out of making a decision.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I don't like the sink.
You already said that.
I insist on going halves with the rent.
You'll have to. I can't afford it on my own.
Woo!
Oh, sorry. Sorry, it's only me. Mr. Selby. Any decision from you and your...
Mr. Bell, we're still musing.
Ah, well, musing is fine. I like to think that I muse as much as the next man, but time and tide...
Tide waits for no man.
Yes, exactly. So. See, the thing is, I've got Mr. and Mrs. Swallow downstairs in the back of the metro, and they're all terribly excited.
Well, just give us a few more minutes, Mr. Bell.
Yes, very well, but you must see my point of view. I mean, if you're going to say no, I can't afford to let the Swallows become agitated.
Well,
highly strung couple, are
they? No, quite. Just a few more minutes.
Right.
Well, you heard what he said. Can't afford to let the Swallows become agitated.
Well, blow the Swallows. I'm the one who's been asked to rush into a decision.
What rush?
A couple of minutes, you say.
Well, no, not literally. We can hang it out to about another 10.
Oh, terrific.
Well, in any case, you have the whole day to think about the principle of the thing and a good hour to look around the flat, and you're still having an hour.
Well, I'll have an hour as long as I like.
Until we lose the flat. And then somebody else will take it. And then you won't have any decision to make, which is probably what you wanted all along.
Where are you going?
I'm going to unagitate the Swallow.
No!
You mean you want us to take it?
What do you think?
Oh, I've told you what I think. It's a big flat. It's big enough for two people to live in it. Well, why shouldn't we be the two people?
Supposing we get on each other's nerves?
Well, that wouldn't be the flat's fault. We get on each other's nerves anyway.
I'm getting on your nerves now, aren't I?
Yes, you are, as a matter of fact.
Now, how are we doing?
We're getting on each other's nerves.
Oh. Still, what couple doesn't from time to time? My own good lady, you know, as a matter of fact, has this habit of... But I digress. The thing is, I must have a decision. You see, the Swallows have become adamant.
They fairly zip through the old emotions, don't they?
As I might say that you appear to be doing the same thing. Oh, dear. The Swallows are hooting now. Look, I'm sorry, but I must have a decision, yes or no.
Yes.
No.
Sorry?
Yes! You said no!
No.
You did.
Well, it's just the way I speak. I mean to say yes, and out comes no.
Yes, I see. Well, are you sure?
Yes.
Fine. Well, if you'd like to pop back to the office when you're ready, and we'll sign the necessary papers. In the meantime, I'd better go and mollify the Swallows. I do hope that you'll be very happy here. I'll never give much credence to jinxes, myself.
What jinx? What jinx?
The last two or three couples have moved in and out rather quickly. Not to the cemetery.
Oh. Well, that's something.
Well, there's nothing like crossing the old Rubicon to get the adrenaline flowing, is there?
I think we'd better go and sign those papers before we change our minds.
Yeah, I'll change the sink.
Good.
How do you feel?
Scared. And you?
Oh, well, I've had longer to think about it than you.
True.
Petrified.
A fine romance with no kinches, facing the
like a couple of hot tomatoes. But we're as cold as yesterday's mashed potatoes. Ah, fine romance with no wrestling. Ah, fine romance with no nestling. We two are just as prickly as cactus plants. Love hasn't got a chance. This is a fine romance.